Grand Rising, Grand Rising. Happy Saturday. Yesterday I came across this beautiful graphic in words. Made me really stop and think. When people pass, we're quick to say, rest in peace. But why don't we live in peace too? We want peace after death, but we don't seek it in life with one another. That's something to really, really think about. Speaking of, for the mothers, you know, there would never, ever be a day like the day your baby was born. And with that thought, I'm going to think of the mother bee, queen bee, and how she's protected. And I'm going to leave you with these words. Be kind. Be positive. Be humble. Be honest. Be true. Most importantly, being you. Don't let people dim your light. Don't dumb down. Be grateful for who God blessed you to be. Remembering, He knew you before you were in your mother's womb. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. If there's anyone around you that makes you question yourself or doubt yourself, I don't care who they are. Mother, father, sister, brother, child, friend, husband, free yourself. Free yourself. God says, if they are not for you, they are against you. Today is my 126th day. My 126th post for the 254-day challenge. I thank you for stopping by. If you're not familiar with this channel, I am Fly for 44, meaning first love you. My focus here, theory says, it takes anywhere from 21 days to 254 days to form a habit. Initially when starting this channel, back in the day, Priester Studio, I don't know what I started it for. Just folks around me had a YouTube channel, so I launched me one. During the time, I was developing websites for nonprofits, small businesses, nonprofits, and childcare facilities. Finding me, discovering my first business and what I would like to. I've been all over the place. What I'm discovering here is in my healing, I find that a part of healing, it's very important for you to take a look at yourself and look at the role that you played in your pain. For example, have you been obedient or sacrificed in a way the Lord would have? Then you might have been able to avoid this specific pain. Today's scripture for the day, Romans 1:17. The good news shows how God makes people right with himself. God's way of making people right begins and ends with faith. As the scripture says, glory to God. The one who is right with God by faith, the one who is right with God by faith will live forever. It's faith, my friend. It's faith. Romans 1, greetings from Paul, a servant of Christ Jesus. God chose me to be an apostle and gave me the work of telling his good news. God promised long ago through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures to give this good news to his people. The good news is about God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As a human, he was born from the family of David. But through the Holy Spirit, he was shown to be God's powerful son. Hallelujah. When he was raised from death, do you believe? Do you believe? Through Christ, God gave me, us, the special work of an apostle to lead people of all nations to believe and obey him. I do all this to honor Christ. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You are some of those who have been chosen to belong to Jesus Christ. This letter is to all of you in Rome. God loves you, and he has shown you to be his holy people. My sisters and brothers, we are in Rome. This letter is too for us. For God loves us. He has chosen us. Many are called, but few are chosen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Many are called, but few are chosen. Few are chosen. It just came across my spirit. And many are called, few are chosen. Many are called. It's plenty of work to do. There's plenty of work to do. But the labors are few. The labors are the chosen ones. Are you a servant of Christ Jesus? Are you dividing, or are you pulling together? I was looking at a clip the other day, and I was thinking, they talk about celebrities and their fame and them selling their souls to the devil. And I came across the clip where he gave scripture about who owns these souls. Who owns these souls? Our God, Father God, Christ Jesus owns these souls. So if the souls are owned by Christ Jesus, how is folks so-called selling their souls? You can't sell something that doesn't belong to you. Unless you stole it. So who are these souls being sold to? Oh, it's the devil? No. He ain't buying nothing. He comes to kill it, steal it, or destroy it. He comes to kill it, steal it, or destroy it. But God's will be done. Choices, free will is how we may end on the other side. Pick a side. Pick a side. God's going to bless the educated as well as the weak, the ignorant. That's why telling the good news is important. So people can learn. Many times it's the following because of the culture and what they're used to. But when we know better, we do better. Because it is the power of God that uses to save everyone who all you have to do is just simply believe that Christ Jesus is his son and that he died on the cross for our sins, and then defeated death and rose on the third day. on the third day. And whether Jew or not non-Jew, if this is your belief, you are a son of God. You are an heir to Christ. The good news shows how God makes people right with himself. God's way of making people right begins and ends with faith. Faith. As the scriptures say, the one who is right with God by faith will live forever. Forever. Faith. How do we get faith? By hearing the word of God. From faith to faith, staying in the word of God. God shows his anger from heaven against all the evil and wrong things that people do. The evil lives that hide the truth they have. And this makes God angry. Because we have been shown what it is he likes. He has made it very clear to us. If it's not clear to you, then you need to get in that book, the Bible, and study to show thyself approved. For the things that God made clear, his eternal power, and all that makes him God since the beginning of the world. I don't know about you, but it's clear to me. So people have no excuse for the evil in which you do. And we know the difference between good and bad. But God said that there was going to come a time where good would be called bad and bad would be called good. You know the difference. Our helper who was left here until Jesus returned goes before us, leads, and directs. That is where you're to be guided and led. Not by the world. Be wise, not fools. Honoring the divine greatness of God who lives forever. Trade up your idols for worshiping the Lord. Put down those things that are not of God. Talking to self. You know the difference between what's right and what's wrong. For the people that wanted to do evil, you know that God left them and let them go to their way, to that sinful way. Where becoming immoral, shameful. Trading the truth, trading the truth of God for a lie, bowing down and worshiping the things that God made instead of the maker. It's the plan in the hands of the enemy. We know. But do we believe? It's the faith. The faith. The substance of things hope for. It saddens me for the lack of understanding, the lack of knowledge in the power that we have. I'm talking to self. Waste of time. A lot of waste of time. A lot of going against the grain. Or not. The simple folding of the arms. Romans today, Lord, we're coming to a close. Take a look at yourself in the mirror and ask this question. Are you in alignment with the will of God on your life? Are you? Are you doing what? Or things, are you doing things that you should not? Are you greedy? Are you hateful? Are you a murderer? Are you a liar? Are you jealous of your neighbor? Are you rude? Are you a gossiper? Do you brag about earthly things, earthly possessions? If this is you, it's not too late. You can turn from your wicked ways, repent, ask the Lord for forgiveness. And turn from your wicked ways. Meaning, when you ask for forgiveness, He will forgive. Now it's up to you to press forward and don't look back. Don't go back there. Don't go back there. To repent is to turn away from it and to not to do it again. And when you repent, you know that it's wrong. So when you continue in it, now it's an intentional sin. And that's against God. He says, if you are not for me, his ways, his thoughts, you are against him. So if you're engaging in any type of division, you're against God. And what I'm going to tell you that you should know, no one can block your blessings. No one. But you can. You can, by the choices that you make. You might not be getting all that's due to you, because our Father has to hold back, send you back to school, back to training. She needs some additional training. He needs some additional training. Romans. That's the book for the day. Romans 1. I'm going to call this a wrap. I thank you for joining me. I appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed, do subscribe. Hit like if you liked. If this something touched you, if this just was totally off to you, hit dislike. I still appreciate you. Today is Saturday. It's going to be a beautiful day. This is the day that the Lord made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.